All right, Cardinal basketball. Oopsie daisy. Here we go. Cardinal basketball here on AUSA from the Andreas and Health and Wellness Center on the campus of Andrews University in Berrien Springs, Michigan. It's the Andrews Cardinals, the three-time USCAA men's basketball team against the Great Lakes Christian College Crusaders from Lansing, Michigan. Cardinals trying to get a win here tonight. We got another game coming up on Saturday night at 9 o'clock against Jackson College, but right now you got to concentrate on the Crusaders of Great Lakes Christian College. Today's game brought to you by AUSA, the Andrews University Student Association YouTube channel, and Andrews University. Quality education, close to home. Andrews University. Seek knowledge, affirm your faith, and change the world. The Cardinals and the Crusaders coming up next with opening prayer in the starting lineups. The men's game next. The ladies' game was close one. The Lady Cardinals beating the Lady Crusaders by 5 in a nail-biter. 68-63. Well, I got to check that score. But anyway, they got the victory. I can tell you that solidly. I have to go back and look at my notes. But the Lady Cardinals with a victory in the earlier game, so let's see what the men can do in the late game. Cardinals coming up next against the Crusaders. Listening to Cardinal basketball, www.aucardinals.com, or go to the Andrews University Cardinals website. You can find it on the athletic department website on Andrews University's website, www.andrews.edu. And you can watch the games. All you got to do is go to the athletic department website. Every home game, all you got to do is click watch live, and you're there. Here we go, Cardinals and the Crusaders.
Jones. Head coach of the Crusaders is Richard Westerlund. Assistant Connor Hobbs. Assistant Lance Adams. Assistant Cam Nottage. And assistant Jared Wilson Sanders.
Cardinals first attempt there on O goes by the wayside. They come off empty. Shot on the left side, no good by the Crusaders. 23 Reed with the miss. Cardinals come back on offense on the other side. Weathers with the ball, tries to shoot, misses. Denzel Daniel, the offensive board. He has a shot blocked out of bounds, leaving 17 on the shot clock for the Cardinals. Good block there by number 10 Jones for the Crusaders. It is Cardinal ball, Anderson to inbound. It's a two Fitzpatrick, out to Weathers. Weathers with the ball, swings it left. Anderson looking for help. Fitzpatrick, we only got 9 on the shot clock. In the lane, back outside, Anderson for 3. Can't get it to go. And a defensive rebound by the Crusaders. That was 23, Reed with the rebound. Back outside, Reed right side. They're playing catch, Reed way out there on the right. Now they go down low. Shot down low by Anderson, no good. For the Crusaders, and Denzel Daniel with the rebound for the Cardinals. So the Cardinals have the ball, but still no scoring yet. Both teams have had a couple opportunities here offensively, but both have come up empty. Fitzpatrick with the ball on the left side, 13 on the shot clock, back to Weathers. Weathers driving in the baseline. Weathers in the paint, dumps it back to Fitzpatrick for the shot, can't get it to go. Weathers offensive board though. Dumps it back out, Anderson, over to Dronin. Dronin, a good pass inside to Daniel. Now they back out, 14 on the shot clock for the Cardinals. Now a give and go. Denzel Daniel, the senior, finds a streaking Fitzpatrick in the lane for the bucket, and the Cardinals break the ice here and score the first one of the night. And they go up by a 2 mark, 2-0. Back the other way now come the Crusaders. Right side, long 3, no good by Reed. And quickly back the other way come the Cardinals on offense. Fitzpatrick across the center line for Andrews. Fitzpatrick looking for help. Flings it right to Denzel Daniel. Daniel with the ball. Out left, it's Dronin now top the key for the Cardinals. Just now backs up beyond the arc over to Anderson. Swings it in the lane, fadeaway shot in the lane by Fitzpatrick, no good. Cardinals worked it for a shot but could not get it to go. Quickly back the other way, pass down low, good by Anderson. for the Crusaders, who get their first bucket tonight. It was Evan Anderson with that bucket. 2-2 tie now. Cardinals with the ball. Weathers. Weathers trying to drive. Weathers, good move. Shoots from just beyond the top of the key and gets the bucket for the Cardinals, and they go up 4-2. The Cardinals have maintained a two-point lead here early. Crusaders with the ball. Jones swings it in the lane. Shot up, no good by Eggleston. And a jump ball underneath, and this time possession arrow belongs to the Cardinals. Cardinal ball, and they lead 4-2, and now we got a discussion. Oh yeah, if the Cardinals have the ball, they're going to inbound underneath their own hoop. So no discussion, just trying to sort it out here briefly. Here we go. Transition shot by Weathers, no good. Put back by Daniel for the bucket. Cardinals up 6-2 now. Back down the other way come the Crusaders. 22 Temple with the ball, swings it outside to Jones. Jones back out right, back and forth with the catch to Temple. Temple gonna drive, dumps it back out. 23 Reed takes the shot from the corner, no good for the Crusaders, and quickly back, 3-on-1 break for the Cardinals, and it's Fitzpatrick with the feed from Weathers. Cardinals up 8-2, back the other way is Eggleston. Then the Cardinals couldn't get back, and Eggleston gets the bucket for the Crusaders, and it's 8-4. Weathers across the center line, back the other way for the Cardinals, dumps it back out to Daniel, top the key, Dronan, outside to Anderson, back in the left corner, Fitzpatrick, inside the lane to Denzel Daniel, turn around, dipsy-doo drive, and looking for the bucket, and gets it as Denzel Daniel. 10-4, Cardinals in the lead, 15-35 remaining in the first half. Cardinals with a six-point lead early. Crusaders with the ball, shot left corner, up and good on the three-pointer by Jaquin Jones to make it 10-7. Cardinals with a three-point lead now. Fitzpatrick across the center line for Anders, over to Weathers, over to Anderson now. Anderson shot from top the key, good for the Cardinals to make it 12-7. Well, now Anderson from British Columbia, Canada with the bucket, 12-7 now, Cardinals in the lead. Now another three-pointer on the left. No good by Jones. Defensive rebound for the Cardinals by Weathers. Over to Fitzpatrick. Back to Dronan. Dronan dumps it top over or across the arc to Fitzpatrick. Over to Daniel in the corner to Dronan, who had his shot blocked up. And Dronan had a shot blocked there and then recovered. And the ball goes out. It was able to get that to go off of the... Well, we got a sub into the game, number 32, Garrett, into the game for the Crusaders. That was a way to stay with it for Dronan. Had it partially blocked, but remained in the play and was able to have that ball get knocked off the Crusaders out of bounds. Cardinals inbound now. They have the ball. Weathers with it on the right, over to Daniel. You got 8 seconds on the shot clock. Cardinals swing it left to Fitzpatrick, wide open. Takes the shot, makes the three-pointer, and the Cardinals are now up 15-7. Big three-pointer by the veteran senior Joshua Fitzpatrick. 14-20 remaining in the first half. Crusaders with the ball. Cardinals with an 8-point lead. Three-pointer left side. Good. And number 23 Reed answers the three-pointer of Fitzpatrick. That is now 15-10. Back the other way come the Cardinals. Clock for the Cardinals. 13:36 left in the half. Fitzpatrick with the ball, swings it right to Anderson. Anderson goes down low. Fitzpatrick on a beautiful pass by Anderson. Cardinals get the streaking Fitzpatrick going to the hoop there, and it's 17-10. Good pass by Anderson. Back the other way now. Crusaders with the ball. Garrett with it. Back out top they go. Reed, cross court pass to Jones. Now they're going all the way around the arc. The three-pointer by Reed is good. On the left side for the Crusaders, and it's 17-13 now. 4-point ball game, and the Crusaders hanging close. The Cardinals made. And the putback, no good by Weathers, and the Cardinals had two good chances there but could not come up with it. Cardinals see their lead cut to two. 12 minutes to go here in the first half. Weathers is fouled in the backcourt by the Crusaders, and that's our first foul of the game. It took a good while to get one. It's first team foul on the Crusaders, and the foul is on number 15, Jamal Eggleston. And now 22 for the Cardinals. Let's check that. Cardinals bring someone in off the bench. Let's check it here. 22 Cassell into the game. They got. And the ball intercepted by number 15, Eagleson. Now the ball pulled away by Phil. Garrett back up top to Jones. Jones in the right corner. Raiders have. We've seen got a tie game, I should say, as Cole from off the bench there with an effort. And we got a timeout by Coach Pallas here of the Cardinals with the game tied now at 17 after the Cardinals led most of that exchange. But now I've seen that lead dissipate, and well, we're tied at 17. Goes to show tonight, no lead has been safe. Same thing happened in the ladies game. The Lady Cardinals led by as many as 12 for hanging on for a victory in the earlier game. And now we got the late game here, and the Cardinals got out to the lead, but right back come the Crusaders to tie it up at 17 here. Timeout on the court. You're listening to Cardinal Basketball, brought to you by Andrews University. Quality education, close to home, and brought to you by Andrews University. Andrews University, seek knowledge, affirm your faith, and change the world. The Cardinals and the Crusaders. 17-17 tie. Time running down on this timeout. First half coverage here from the Andreasen Health and Wellness Center on the campus of Andrews University. Cardinals come out of the huddle with, Cassell, Dronan, and now we got Barry Armstrong into the game now for the Cardinals. And they also have Denzel Daniel and Fitzpatrick out there. Cardinals across the center line. Denzel Daniel with the ball over to Armstrong. Armstrong looking for help, back to Daniel. Cross court to Dronan. Dronan with the ball, top the key, Anderson. Armstrong. Armstrong with the ball. Cardinals down to five on the shot clock. They go to the right corner, and there he is. Good shot by the Cardinals, number 22, Cassell, with the bucket for the Cardinals. 19-17 Cardinal lead. Nice shot by Cassell. Now the Crusaders go with the three-pointer by Jones, and he gets it to go. And now that's the first lead of the game for the Crusaders. They're up 20-19 now on that three-pointer by Jake Will Jones. Armstrong with the ball. Goes to the right to Fitzpatrick. We're at the 10-minute mark left here in the first half. Fitzpatrick with the ball. Goes left to Dronan. Dronan now to Armstrong. Right to the right side, Fitzpatrick. We're down to 10 on the shot clock. Over to
Purcell takes the shot, no good. Tip in by Fitzpatrick. And the Cardinals go up 24-20. 4-point Cardinal lead after the brief 1-point lead by the Crusaders. 9:13 to go in the half. April Jones playing the catch out there. Dumps it left. Shot no good by Reed.
A read on if that was Reed. Maybe it wasn't. I'm going to have to check that number. These are dark blue and dark black shirts. It is 23 Reed. Sideline off Armstrong. So now we got more subs in. 25 right into the game. Crusaders. Cardinals bring in number 2 Owen Fainter into the game. So subs continue on both sides. 8:44 to go in the half on the Cardinals with a 4-point lead, 24-20 at the moment. Top the key right, close left side, and it's 22 Temple dumping it back inside to Garrett for the drive, and Garrett draws the foul, and that's going to be on Cassell, his first, Cardinals first. Now it's a 3-point biggest lead of the night for the Crusaders. Full court pressure has done this, and another Cardinal turnover in the backcourt. As Fitzpatrick was stripped, that results in a bucket by number 20, Riley. And the Cardinals continue having a turnover problem in this backcourt. Now down by 5, 29-24. Fainter with the ball across center court to Daniel over to Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick turnaround layup in the lane, couldn't get it to go. And the rebound goes to the number 20, Riley, for the Crusaders, who now have a 5-point lead, and they have the ball with 6:20 to go. And now a drive inside by the Crusaders on that transition, and Temple will go to the line, and now it's a 7-point. Momentum shift here as the is now quiet. The Cardinals had an early lead in this game and then saw it completely liquidate. More subs in the game. Jaquel Jones back in, number 10. Number 15, Eggleston back in for the Crusaders, as we've got two team fouls now on the Cardinals. That foul was on 15 Armstrong. 22 at the line is Trent Temple, the junior from Detroit, Michigan. Gets the free throw to go, and that's a three-point play for him. Cardinals trail at 32-24, down by eight. Here's Weathers with a ball on the inbound. They get it to Armstrong. Armstrong into Fitzpatrick. And Fitzpatrick with a ball, driving to the hoop, scoring for the Cardinals. Good, strong move by Josh Patrick. 32-24. The other end by the Crusaders. Goes out of bounds off of Riley. And the Cardinals are going to get it back with 6 minutes to go in the half, down by six. Here they go. It's Weather. It. Jones the rebound for the Crusaders. Five and a half to go in the half. Cardinals down by six, 32. Get the ball back. They need some points here. Backcourt pressure again put on by the Crusaders. Now stolen away on the left sideline by 15 Eggleston. And the Crusaders have it back, and now we got another whistle. Ball with 27 on the shot clock. The Crusaders will maintain possession, and now more subs. Evan Anderson, number 12, back in for the Crusaders. And 20. Line corner, good by number 12, Anderson, who just came off the bench. Beating Anderson to the line. And the Cardinals make it a 34-29 ball game, down by five here with 4:52 remaining in the first half. Crusaders with the ball. Temple looking for help. Temple trying to drive, cut off, double team, dumps it back. Jones for a three-pointer on the left side. Oh, boy, that really hurts. Now it's an eight-point Crusader lead, 37-29. More backcourt pressure put on by the Crusaders. They get it across to Armstrong, who takes the three and then comes right back to equal Jones's three. Nice three-pointer by Barry Armstrong, and it's 37-32, back to a five-point game. Exchanging three-pointers there. Here's a shot left baseline, no good by 22 Temple. Cardinals get the rebound from Weathers over to Fitzpatrick across the center line. Now Weathers top the key. 3:58 remaining in the first half. Weathers trying to drive. Weathers down. Oh, tried to hit for Patrick, who was cutting from the left side and overshot him, and that's a Cardinal turnover. 3:53 to go in the half, and the Cardinals down by 5, 37-32. So, well, not been easy tonight. Not been. For the Cardinals. 3:35 remaining in the half. They get it over to Armstrong, trying to get across the center line. Ooh, ball intercepted almost by the Crusaders. Knocked out of bounds. Cardinal ball with 21 on the shot clock. Cardinals having some fits getting across the center line with that, trying to beat the 5 second violation with that full court pressure put on by the Crusaders. Weathers with the ball now for the Cardinals off the give and go. Oh my. Weathers gave it to Daniel, the give and go dunked by Fitzpatrick, folks. And the Cardinals back within three, 37-34. The veteran Fitzpatrick with the slam dunk. Here come the Crusaders now, and a good move down the lane by number 15, Eggleston, and that makes it 39-34. Quickly back, non-phased are the Crusaders from the dunk by Fitzpatrick. 2:55 to go in the first half. Weathers with the ball, Cardinals trying to break the center line here. They get it to Daniel. And now down low, they try to go to Fitzpatrick. Another errant pass there by the Cardinals goes out of bounds. And timeout by the Crusaders here. They'll get the ball back on that Cardinal turnover with 2:46 left in the half. It's the Cardinals 34, the Crusaders 39. You're listening to Cardinal Basketball on AUSA. Well, more Cardinal basketball coming up on Saturday night. Saturday night, some ball games. That's next on tap here, the last games of 2019. Jackson College in here on Saturday night for a 7 o'clock ladies game and a 9 o'clock men's game. Come on down to the Andreasen, brand new Andreasen Health and Wellness Center on the campus of Andrews University here in Berrien Springs, Michigan to watch those two games, our last two home games of 2019. And then after that, the Cardinals will wait till January 7th when they have two home games, a 5:30 ladies start and a 7:30 men's start that day against the Kent State University Tuscaroras, who come in for that game, the first game of 2020 of the new year. A 5-point deficit for the Cardinals in this timeout as we get to the waning moments of the first half. Crusaders of the Great Lakes Christian College from Lansing, Michigan, 39. The Andrews Cardinals, 34. So, got a ways to go in this one. Cardinals had the early lead in this one. First part of the first half was theirs, and the second part of the first half has been the Crusaders. We now have a 5-point lead. Come out of the timeout, it'll be Crusader ball. Crusaders bring it in on the whistle here and bringing it down 22 Temple with the ball. Back outside playing catch for 23 Reed. Reed now playing catch with Jones, drives, one-handed shot in the lane, good. Good play there by Reed and Jones on that left side to get a bucket. 41-34, Great Lakes Christian College in the lead. Weathers with the ball for the Cardinals, trying to get across the center line, has to dump it off, and it's stolen away by Eggleston, and Jockwell Jones quickly back the other way for the bucket, and another Cardinal turnover in the backcourt results in a basket for the Crusaders. Just having a hard time with this press and this pressure defense. Denzel Daniel across the center line for the Cardinals. And now they go down low, and we got a whistle ball knocked out of bounds by the Crusaders. Cardinals are going to have 21 left on the shot clock, but they're in got a big problem here. They're down 43-34 here with a minute 52 to go in the half. They have just not been able to, once the Crusaders went into that press defense, that's what changed this whole momentum of this game. Here's Denzel Daniel now fouled on the play. We'll go to the line for the Cardinals. Third team foul on the Crusaders. 15 Eggleston with a foul, it looks like. Denzel Daniel with a desperate need for these free throws to help the Cardinals. Fourth team foul on the Crusaders. It was on Temple, correction, not Eggleston. His first, and Denzel Daniel hits the free throw to make it 43-35. And a pair by Denzel Daniel, the veteran senior, with the pair of free throws, 43-36. Cardinals needed those. Quickly back the other way on the Crusaders on the attack. Down low, right-handed shot no good by 15 Eggleston. Denzel Daniel the rebound for the Cardinals. Cardinals have the ball down 43-36. Armstrong across the center line. Armstrong with the ball for the Cardinals, 19 on the shot clock. Armstrong looking for help, swings it left to Daniel. Top the key, back outside, Armstrong for three, can't get it to go. Jones, the rebound for the Crusaders. Back quickly over to Temple for the shot. No good. Offensive rebound and put back. No good. Weathers, the rebound for the Cardinals. It's a 3-on-2 break for Andrews. He stops and shoots from just inside the free throw line. Weathers, but could not get it to go. And Eggleston, the rebound. Number 12, Anderson with the rebound for the Crusaders. Final minute to the first half, and the Cardinals down 43-36. And Jones with the ball, swings it in the left corner, and a three-pointer in the corner by Reed. Now it's a 10-point. 10-point Crusader lead, 46-36. Anderson with the ball, swings it to Weathers. Cardinals trying to get it across the center. They go to Daniel, back outside Armstrong for three. Larry Armstrong with a big three-pointer for the Cardinals. And it's 46-39, a 7-point game now with the final 15 seconds of the half ticking down. With the ball is Temple for the Crusaders, who are content to go for the final shot. Bangs it left. Buy-in catch with Reed. Back to Temple. Left corner, Jones. Back to Reed for three. Can't get it to go. Daniel, the rebound as the clock expires for the Cardinals. And we are at the end of the first half here at the Andreasen Center. It's the Andrews Cardinals trailing the Great Lakes Christian College Crusaders 46-39 at the half. And I can tell you, Cardinals came out good in that first part of the first half. But then the Crusaders came out with a pressure defense and a full court press and a man-on-man, and it really gave fits to the Cardinals, and they fell short and got behind, but they battle back to get within seven here before the half. Well, we go to halftime. We'll give you the halftime stats coming up in a few minutes. Don't go away. You're listening to Cardinal Basketball on AUSA. The Cardinals down by seven at the half, 46-39 here, folks. We're on winter break right now at the university, so we don't have any halftime entertainment. The crowd a little bit thinner than normal, but not without enthusiasm. The Cardinals trail it, though, 46-39. So today's ball game brought to you by Andrews University. Quality education close to home. And some more things to know. More Cardinal games coming up on Saturday night. We'll be on for our last home games broadcast on AUSA. Saturday night game coming up here, the 14th, December 14th, a Saturday. 6 out of 14 from three-point land for the Crusaders. That's 43%. Cardinals also fairly well. 4 out of 9 from the beyond the arc. 44% from there. 3 for 3 from the line for the Cardinals. 2 for 3 from the line for the Great Lakes Christian College Crusaders. Cardinals have out-rebounded the Crusaders 24 to 13, but the problem is turnovers. Cardinals have 12 to only 2 for the Crusaders. So the score is 46-39 at the half. Cardinals trail. They've got work cut out in the second half. So, yeah. The scoring spread out a little bit for the Crusaders. 11 for Jones, 4 for Anderson, 6 for Eggleston, 7 for Temple, 11 for Reed, 2 for Cole and Wright, and 3 for Garrett for a total of 46. Cardinals 39 there. Got big numbers from Fitzpatrick with 15 and 9 for Denzel Daniel. Then you got 6 from Armstrong, 5 from Weathers, and 2 from Cassell, 2 from Anderson for a total of 39. Cardinals led by as many as 8, but now the Great Lakes Christian College is led by as many as 10. It was a two-sided first half. The Cardinals had the first part of that first half. Great Lakes Christian College controlled the second part of that first half. Lead changed 3 times. Score was tied twice. Cardinals led by 8, but then lost that lead, and the Great Lakes led by as many as 10. But it's a 7-point Great Lakes Christian College Crusader lead at the half. So there you have it. Second half coming up. The Cardinals and the Crusaders from the Andreasen Center and Health and Wellness Center here on the campus of Andrews University. Don't go away. Second half coming up in about 6.5 minutes. Thank you. Well, here we go. Second half, 3 minutes away. New camera person? Oh, okay. Sometimes they switch the camera person on me, but not tonight. Yeah, just gotta check out all their messages. Okay. Getting all the equipment messages and things here, making sure everybody's on the same page. Got the scorekeeper, the clock manager, and all kinds of people working hard here tonight. 46 for the Crusaders of Great Lakes Christian College. Cardinals 39. It's a seven-point game here with 2 minutes left in the halftime intermission. Final minutes of warm-up between both teams. Cardinals have to figure out a way to break that full-court pressure and man-on-man defense and backcourt problems they've had with turning the ball over on that. Gave up a lot of points in that situation, and they're down by seven only. They can still right this ship. Got to figure out what to do here with a minute to go in halftime intermission. Otherwise, the game has been pretty close. If you take away the turnovers, 12 for the Cardinals, 2 for the Tate, 2 for the Crusaders. That's your big difference right now. Cardinals, they dominated the rebounding there at 24 rebounds, only 13 rebounds for the Crusaders. So the big problem right now, the big problem lately has been the turnovers. To see if they can get rid of that, they might really be able to make a run here in the second half. They come out with their starters, Fitzpatrick, Dronan, Weathers, Anderson, and of course Denzel Daniel. So here we go. 20 minutes of ball left here, and then we'll see what this situation brings us. Here we go. The Crusaders with the ball first to begin the second half. 22, Temple brings it up. Goes right to Jones. Jones with the ball. Across the three-point land, dumps it inside. Shot from top to key, no good by 15 Eggleston, and the Cardinals get the rebound between Fitzpatrick, Daniel, and Weathers down there. So the Cardinals have the ball after the Crusaders fail on their first attempt on offense in the second half. Denzel Daniel with the ball in the paint. Now he backs out of there, fadeaway shot, up and no good. Battle for the rebound, Crusaders with a little bad luck there. Two guys went up for the rebound and went off of 23. Reed out of bounds. Cardinals are going to get a new 30-second clock out of it. Anderson inbound. Gets it inside to Fitzpatrick, who's stripped the ball, knocked out of bounds, though, by Eggleston. And now 27 on the shot clock. Cardinals get another inbound opportunity. Cardinals with a ball down by seven. No one scored yet here in the second half. Inbound to Daniel underneath the hoop. The Cardinals get the bucket. They were persuasive there, and they were persistent. 46-41 now the ball game. Five-point Crusader lead. Jones with the ball just beyond the arc. Drives in there. Dumps it off in the corner to Reed. Now they go around the horn. Temple over to Jones. Back to Temple. Temple now trying to drive. Goes in the lane. Dumps it in. The streaking shot no good on the left baseline by Anderson. Fitzpatrick the rebound for the Cardinals, who are quickly back down the other way. They go to Weathers in the lane. Weathers back out to Daniel. Cardinals have 19 on the shot clock, trying to work another basket here. Fitzpatrick with a ball. Fitzpatrick in the lane, shoots off the window and good. Cardinals back within three, 46-43 now, with 18:31 to go in the ball game. Back the other way now come the Crusaders. Reed with the ball, swings it to Temple, back to Reed, back to Temple, cross-court pass to Jones, now out to Reed inside the lane, it's 15 Eggleston, turnaround shot off the window and good. Well, they worked the ball well there, the Crusaders did, to break the 4-0 run by the Cardinals. 48-43 ball game now. Back to a full court press now put on by the Crusaders. Beaten quickly by the Cardinals. Weathers across the center line. That was a good play by the Cardinals there. That was that time they broke the press quite well. Weathers with it. Just beyond the arc. 15 on the shot clock. Gets it inside Denzel Daniel. Daniel now trying to go give and go out to Anderson. Now down the baseline to Dronin, and he stepped on the line. Well, Dronin tried to save that one. Could not stay in bounds. And now Garrett, number 32, checks in for the Crusaders. And that's too bad. A turnover by the Cardinals there. They needed to keep it going. 48-43 ball game with 17:38 to go. Cardinals trying to pull out a win here and make a come. First half by 10, but now trailed by as many as 12, but now they're battling back within five here. Shot down low, no good by Garrett. Cardinals with the rebound by Weathers. Now they dump it to Daniel, right corner Dronin. Top the key, Daniel. Oh, ball knocked out of bounds by the Crusaders. 17-12 on the game clock. Cardinal ball on the side. Anderson inbounds it to Weathers. The Cardinals have stayed with their starters so far the first 3 minutes of this second half. Weathers over to Dronin. Dronin fakes the shot, goes to the right corner to left corner to Fitzpatrick. Drives in the lane, dumps it back to Weathers. Now the cross court to Anderson for the shot. Oh, he had a good look and could get it to go. Cardinals worked it to a good shot, but could not get it to go. 48-43 still, 5-point lead for the Crusaders. Back the other way, Crusaders with a ball, shot right side, no good. Shot no good by, looks like 23, Reed. Now back the other way come the Cardinals. Fitzpatrick with the ball. Still a 5-point lead by the Crusaders. Fitzpatrick driving to the hoop is fouled on the play. So he'll go to the line. That's our first foul of the second half. All right, well, shooting foul sends the senior Joshua Fitzpatrick from Lansing, Michigan to the line. Cardinals need these free throws. Fouls on number 22, Temple, is second. And the first team foul the second half on the Crusaders. 16-27 to go in the ball game, and a nice free throw by Fitzpatrick to make it a 4-point ball game. 48-44 now. Another big free throw coming up here to make it a one possession game. And he does. Well, it's 48-45. Temple to inbound for the Crusaders. Bringing it up now, Eggleston back to Temple. Swings it left to Reed. Top to key, driving Temple in the lane. Shoots and misses. That's Patrick the rebound. And he brings it through the double team. Fitzpatrick with a beautiful move. And it's 1-point game, 48-47. And that was all Fitzpatrick right there, breaking the press, dribbling through the pressure, and then slicing through the lane for the bucket. Jones with the ball, swings it right, down low they go for the Crusaders, and it's blocked. Fitzpatrick picks up the foul, and getting inside was Eggleston to draw the foul for the Crusaders, and that'll be a foul, first team foul on the Cardinals of the second half. First foul of the second half for the Cardinals, and the first foul on Fitzpatrick tonight. 15-53 to go in the ball game, a 1-point Crusader lead. So it remains a 1-point game as number 35 Wiley checks in for the Cardinals. He came off the bench in the last home game to provide a 3-point spark that helped the Cardinal cause in their 1-point win the other night. Here comes another free throw for the Crusaders. No, he missed it. 0 for 2 now on the line there. Cardinals have the ball and they're only down by one. Wiley brings it up for the Cardinals. Back to Dronin in the corner. Dronin trying to shake and bake, gets it to Denzel Daniel. Daniel double team, back out Anderson for the shot. Anderson for three on the feed from Daniel, and the Cardinals recapture the lead, 58. Cardinals playing strong to begin this first part of the second half. Now the ball knocked away almost there on the defense by Dronin. Shot no good in the lane by the Crusaders, and now we got a whistle, and that's in there was 15 Eggleton. We got people down. One of them down was dead. And that's the ball out off the Cardinals. The Crusader ball. Jones the inbound for the Crusaders. Gets it inbounded to 15, Eggleston. Back to the right side. They go to Reed. Over to Garrett. Top the key for the shot. No good. And it's Weathers with the rebound for the Cardinals. Weathers over to Anderson across the timeline. And then across just beyond the arc is Weathers with 17 on the shot clock. Over to Wiley. Over to Weathers off from Anderson on the left side now. 9 on the shot clock for the Cardinals. Weathers in trouble. Cardinals running out of time. And we got a whistle and a foul by the Crusaders with 2 seconds left on the shot clock. That's what you call a bailout there. Well, let's see if the Cardinals get a new shot clock. There was no shot there, I don't believe. Fouls on number 22, Temple, his third for the Crusaders, their second team foul. And now what do we got here? Yeah, the Cardinals are going to get 20 seconds on the shot clock, a new shot clock here. Whistle and stop and play by the referees, and looks like Anderson inbound for the Cardinals. They get it into Daniel. Daniel looking for help. He's double teamed in the corner, can't get rid of it, and it's stolen away by the Crusaders. Temple with the steal. 2-on-1 break. Jones with the shot on the other end for the Crusaders, and we're tied at 50. Another turnover hurts the Cardinals. Got to shake those off, though. Here's Wiley. Now another turnover at midcourt is Wiley. Now a steal by Weathers. Back. Cardinals have it back, but what are we going to get now? We're going to get a foul on... Well, it appears the Cardinals on Weathers as he tried for that steal. So, boy, I tell you, the Cardinals still having a little problem there. You know, back and forth. It's 2 turnovers in that exchange. And now this game tied at 50 as Weathers is shaken up on the play. And he is bleeding a little bit. He's going to have to come out of the ballgame. You're going to have to have Fitzpatrick check back in. Going to have to get bandaged up before he can return to play. Will they give him a moment to do that? I don't know. They're in an official timeout here, but 14:24 remaining in the contest, and we're tied at 50. What a game here, folks. What a game. Both games tonight have been close and competitive. As Weathers gets his hand wrapped up, and it looks like he's going to have to stay out of the ballgame. Fitzpatrick, nope, he's going to stay in. Just in the nick of time, he comes back in. You only have so much time to get it wrapped and try to come back in. All right, 14:24 left in the game, and the Cardinals 50 and the Crusaders 50. Our trainers have a night tonight wrapping up things. Here we go now out of the timeout. Jones driving to the hoop for the Crusaders. Missed the shot. Garrett the rebound for the Crusaders. Turnaround shot, no good. Denzel Daniel the rebound. Cardinals dodge a bullet. That was 2 in a row. Here's Wiley across the center line for the Cardinals on the right sideline, driving all the way to the hoop. Hook shot in the lane off the window. No good. Still tied at 50. Both teams miss. Back the other way. Crusaders in the lane. And now we got what? We got a jump ball. A jump ball is 15. Eggleston trying to drive. Got tied up under there. And the Cardinals win the ball here as they have the possession arrow. Still tied at 50 in this dogfight. 13:53 to go. Anderson the inbound to Dronin. They're caught in the backcourt. Pass to Weathers over to Denzel Daniel, and they break the press. So they got out of that one, but they only have 15 on the shot clock here. Weathers over to Anderson. 13:36 left in the game. Over to Daniel, right side. 10 on the shot clock to Dronin. Cardinals running out of time here. Down to 4 seconds. Daniel going to have to throw something up. Can't get it to go. And, oh, big offensive rebound by Anderson, though, and the Cardinals get new life. Well, they got the ball, but they got to do something. They got to set something up. Weathers with the ball to Daniel. Daniel, left baseline. Daniel trying to drive, cut off, goes in the corner to Dronin. Dronin shooting, missing. And back the other way, 23 Reed down court to 15 Eggleston, and we got an offensive foul on the Crusaders, Eggleston. And the Cardinals bail it out with some good play there. And that's going to be an offensive foul. Crusaders, their second team foul. And that is the third on Eggleston, number 15. And with 13 minutes left in the game, and subs come in now. Let's see, and getting his hand wrapped up again is Weathers. And let's see who came in now for the Crusaders. I think it was Cole, number 4, checked in. Back to man-on-man defense for the Crusaders. Cardinals ball, we're still tied at 50. Been back and forth in this defensive struggle. A lot of aggressive defensive struggle in this one, and we're deadlocked at 50 here with 13 minutes to go in the contest. Well, here we go. Inbound pass coming up for the Cardinals. Looking for the inbound is Anderson. He gets it to Fitzpatrick. Over to Weathers. They're trying to break the press. They do. Get it to Wiley to Fitzpatrick for the dunk. Cardinals break the press again, and a second dunk of the night by Fitzpatrick. Cardinals up 52-50 now. Coming back from a deficit. Now a three on the left, and Jay Quinn Jones answers the bell of the Fitzpatrick dunk, and they recapture the lead. The Crusaders do 53-51, or 53-52. Here's Denzel Daniel over to Weathers. Weathers trying to drive back to the corner. Wiley for three, can't get it to go. Fitzpatrick the rebound, though, keeps it alive for the Cardinals. Over to Anderson for three, can't get it to go. Another offensive rebound for the Cardinals by Weathers. Cardinals trail by one, but they got the ball three straight times in a row on the offensive boards. Trying to set something up now here to try to recapture the lead. Weathers drives to the lane and scores for the Cardinals. 54-53, Andrews back in the lead in this seesaw battle. Back the other way, three-pointer by Jones again, and he's killing the Cardinals with those three-pointers. That two-point Crusader. 54. Jay Quinn Jones been a real thorn in the side of the Cardinals. Full court press for Andrews now put on by the Crusaders, and the Cardinals break it. Wiley brings it across the center line to Withers. Withers to the lane, draws the foul. They will go to the line for the Cardinals here with a chance to tie the game. That's going to be a foul on the Crusaders. Foul on number 15, his fourth. So foul trouble now starting to hurt the Crusaders at the moment. Number 15, Eggleston, picks up his fourth. One more and he's out of the ballgame. 11:32 to go in the contest. And we got number one, Weathers, at the line for the Cardinals with a chance for the tie. That was the fourth team foul on the Crusaders. Did not get the first free throw. And now number 20, Riley, into the game for the Crusaders. Garrett comes out. Also, number 25, Wright, comes into the game. And that takes number 15, Eggleston, out of the game with four fouls. 11:32 remain. Another free throw for Weathers. He missed them both. No, yes, he did. Offensive rebound, though, by Anderson, who now needs help. Tries to dump it out of there. Couldn't find an outlet, and the ball was stolen by Jones. That's too bad. Wow. Anderson, a great play, but then could not find an outlet. 23 Reed, top the key. Jones swings it right. Three-point shot right is good. Well, a couple of threes by the Crusaders, and now they have a five-point lead, 59-54, after the Cardinals battled back to a small lead. Cardinals break the press. It's Weathers to Fitzpatrick for the bucket. 59-56. Cardinals hanging close with 10:50 to go. Cardinals just need to get out there and not allow any more three-pointers by the Crusaders. Another three on the right side. It's good again. No one got out quick enough, and Reed scores. That's nine straight points all on three-pointers for the Crusaders. They're going to have to come out. Timeout by Coach Pallas. It's the Crusaders 62, Cardinals 56, back to a six-point game. You're listening to Cardinal Basketball on AUSA. The Crusaders answer the Cardinal rally and now open up another six-point lead. Back and forth they go. But this Crusader team is a tough one. The earlier game was the same kind of feel with the ladies holding on at the end to pull out the win over the Lady Crusaders. The Lady Cardinals got the W, but took all they had to get that W, and now the Cardinal men's team's really battling for their lives here in the second half. They had a good first part of the first half and led by as many as eight. And Great Lakes Christian College got up by as many as 10 in that late part of the first half. 7-point halftime lead for the Crusaders. Cardinals battled back to a small lead here in the second half, but the Crusaders have answered right back to take a 6-point lead here. But a lot of time remains in the contest. Cardinals in the timeout, down by six. They gave up three straight three-pointers there. That's a 9-0 9-0 run there by the Crusaders, racing the Cardinal lead and giving them a six-point lead. 10:41 though remains, a lot of time. Cardinals come out with Armstrong off the bench now. They got Denzel Daniel, Fitzpatrick, Weathers, and Wiley in the game. So we'll see what they can do here coming out of this timeout. Here we go. Wiley to bring it up for the Cardinals. Wiley looking for help, gets it over to Armstrong. Armstrong inside to Denzel Daniel. Daniel now double team, breaks out of it, looks over to Armstrong, 15 on the shot clock. Armstrong drives, loses the handle, gets it to Daniel. Daniel now, and we got a whistle, and what's the call? Jump ball, possession arrow goes to the Crusaders. My, oh my. Cardinals having a hard time breaking away from this swarming Crusader defense. And they turn the ball over on the jump ball. Well, that's not what you need. 10:21 to go, and we got liquid on the floor from that exchange, so we got to wipe it off. Quick cleaning of the court, and with 10:21 to go in the contest, the Crusaders have the ball and a six-point lead. My goodness. Here they come, 25 with the ball. Crusaders right with the ball. Wright swings it over to Jones, who's been really hot with the shooting for the Crusaders. Back to 23, Reed. Reed with the ball, looking for help. 13 on the shot clock, down low. They get it to Cole for the bucket. Well, now it's a 64-56 lead for the Crusaders. 8-point ball game. Crusaders have worked it back to an 8-point lead here. Wiley with the ball over to Weathers. Back to Wiley. Back to Weathers. They're playing catch out there with a Denzel Daniel. Ooh, Daniel, ball knocked out of bounds. Tried to get it in the corner to Armstrong, but Wright knocked it out of bounds for the Crusaders. Cardinals left with 18 on the shot clock. Long pass to Weathers on the inbound. Weathers with the ball right to the right side. It's Wiley to the corner. Armstrong for three, can't get it to go. Offensive rebound though by Weathers. Keeps it alive for the Cardinals. Denzel Daniel with the ball now. Cardinals with another opportunity. New life on that rebound. But now they're down to 9 seconds on the shot clock. There's Weathers trying to drive through traffic, loses the ball. Again, you gotta find some answer, and the Cardinals can't do it right now. Good defense by Wright. They get it to left side to Cole for three, can't get it to go. Weathers the rebound for the Cardinals. The Cardinals another opportunity here. They need points desperately here with 8:58 to go. Armstrong with the ball, gets it to the left. Wiley inside to Daniel. Daniel inside Fitzpatrick, back out Weathers. Weathers with a shot, gets it to go. And it's a three-pointer. Got the shooter's roll, 64-59. Back to a five-point game. Big shot by Weathers. Cardinals need some D now. 8:35 remains. Cole with the ball. Back to right, they swing it right to Jones. Down low, 24, back out. Three-point shot, no good by Wright. Cardinals get the rebound. Cardinals twice have stopped them there, and 2 3-point shots missed by the Crusaders, who are living and dying by the three right now. Here's Daniel trying to force it inside of Fitzpatrick. Got the ball stolen. Stolen away at midcourt, though, by Wiley for the Cardinals. Over to Armstrong. Armstrong dumps it inside Weathers for the bucket. Cardinals get a basket on a turnover by the Crusaders. 64-61, Cardinals back within three. 7:55 and long. Crusaders, leaving 8 seconds on the shot clock for the Cardinals. Good defense out there by 22 Temple, who got out there to knock that one away. Very dangerous cross-court pass. Got away with it. Inbound for the Cardinals. Now has it knocked away and stolen away on the inbound by Jones. That's what you can't afford, turnovers. Bucket on the other end for the Crusaders. Number 22, Temple, and that's been the story tonight, turnovers. 69-61, Cardinals trail by 8 again. 6:30 to go. Weathers with the ball, back inside Dronan. Dronan shot right corner, no good. Came up short. And the rebound by the Crusaders, and now they have the ball and an 8-point lead. Things not looking good with 6 minutes left in the game for the Cardinals. Just not able to get another three way out there. No good by Reed. Cardinals get a lucky break. Reed threw that one up from long range. 6 minutes to go. Cardinals call timeout. They have the ball, but they're down by 8. You're listening to Cardinal Basketball on AUSA. Story has been 3-point shooting by the Crusaders, turnovers by the Cardinals. Cardinals have battled back. They've done what they've had to stay in this game, but they have their work cut out, down by 8 here, folks, with about 6 minutes to go. They need something to happen real quick. For the Crusaders of Great Lakes Christian College, 61 for your Andrews Cardinals here with 6 minutes left here at the Andreasen Health and Wellness Center tonight. Ladies already with a W in the books, eking out a victory over the Lady Crusaders earlier tonight. Cardinals men's team trying to get 2-for-2 tonight, but we don't know, we'll see. Don't forget, we got one more Cardinal broadcast coming up Saturday night. The 14th of December, our last live broadcast on AUSA and live in HD on our channel here of Cardinal Basketball. Jackson College in here. 7 o'clock game for the ladies, 9 o'clock game for the men, and we got that coming up on Saturday night here from the Andreasen Center. Weathers with a ball out of the timeout for the Cardinals. They go in the corner to Denzel Daniel. Throw up the three, can't get it to go. Jones the rebound for the Cardinals. So there you go. You live and die by the threes, and right now the battle there is being won by the Crusaders. Jones with the ball as it's stolen away by Anderson. Over to Fitzpatrick. Cardinals with the ball. Weathers driving, dumps it back out. Anderson can't get it to go. Cardinals miss another opportunity on offense after coming up with a good play on D. 5.5 to go in the game. Shot down low, no good by Riley for the Crusaders. Fitzpatrick the rebound. Cardinals have the ball again. They're having opportunities here. They're just not cashing in right at the moment on offense. Anderson with the ball down low, droning in the corner. Denzel Daniel, and he lost his footing trying to make a move in the corner. And that's a turnover. I don't know what's going on. We'll see if this is a turnover or he lost his shoe making that move, and the ball went out of bounds. So well, the Cardinals turn it over again. Bad luck here the last number of times down the court on offense. 5:12 remains, and now the Crusaders have the ball again and an 8-point lead. Cardinals, like the last five times down the court, have come up empty. 5 minutes remaining. Cardinals down by. There. Game now, 71-61 with 4:44 left. Well, I tell you, the enthusiasm not real heavy here right now at the Andreasen Center. Crowd is restless, frustrated. Weathers with the ball left side for the to get it in the corner. Daniel, ball stolen but a recovery by Fitzpatrick. Gets it out to Dronan. Back inside, Denzel Daniel tried to work a shot, couldn't get it to go. And the Cardinals again fail to score. There we go. Well, Reed. And it's a 10-point game again, 73-63. A gallant defensive effort and was able to put it in. He's had a good game tonight for the Cardinals. That's far for Andrews. It's the play of Joshua Fitzpatrick tonight. A couple of dunks, and he's been determined and a really good player for him. He's their Michael Jordan. 73-63, Cardinals trail by 10. With time running down here at the Andreessen Center. Tough ball game. 73-63, Cardinals down. They really need something to happen very quickly. Can do all they can to avoid any more three-pointers by the Crusaders, and also no turnovers. You got to take care of it, and you got to score when you have the ball. So all common sense stuff here with 3:33 left. 3:33 left here at the Andreessen Center, and the Cardinals down by 10. Ten-point Great Lakes Christian College Crusader lead. They have the ball as well. So it's going to be interesting. Crusaders. Two Temple swinging it around with Reed. Reed and Temple. There's three-pointer. They're trying to take away the three-point shot, and that's what happens. Jones driving in, hits Riley for the bucket inside, and then you know you're trying to get out there and spread out, cover the three-point shot, and then they kill you down low. Been a tough night for the Cardinals. 78-66, they trail with 2 minutes to go. Fitzpatrick with the ball for the Cardinals. He's had a good night. Tried to force the ball inside, tried to hit Denzel Daniel in, and another jump ball on that. They got tied up underneath again. The Cardinals do not have the possession arrow. It's going to be Crusader ball, and they have a 78-66 lead here. 12-point game. After the early second half rally by the Cardinals, they got it to a 50-50 tie. They took a small lead at that moment. And since then, it's been all Crusaders this year. Shot down low, good underneath by 22 Temple. The Crusaders now with a 14-point lead, 80-66. That's the biggest lead of the night for either team. Weathers with the ball, back out Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick on a drive, dumps it left in the left corner. It's droning for three, can't get it to go. Ball knocked out of bounds, though, by the Crusaders off of Temple out of bounds. Cardinals get the ball back, but only a minute 23 remains here at the Andreasen Center. Well, I think this game is just about over, and it's going to be very hard to come back from an 80-66 deficit with 1:23 left. Like I say, Cardinals scrapped along. They had a good start to the game, and turnovers kind of hurt them in that late part of the second half, and then three-point shooting in the second half by the Crusaders went crazy, and the Cardinals were never able to keep pace on offense with the Crusaders. Well, there's a missed shot by the Cardinals, and now the Crusaders have the ball with a minute left, and they lead it 80-66. Time running down. This is a sad state of affairs, and now a shot inside, and Anderson picks up the foul, and it'll be a three-point play coming up for the Crusaders as Temple goes to the line. Anderson fouls up. No good. Droning the rebound. 8 seconds to go. Cardinals with the ball, but they're down 82-66. Fitzpatrick back to Droning. Over in the corner. Anderson for the shot. Gets the three-pointer with less than a goal. And that will be the final. 82-69. The Cardinals fall short. They need more of those shots like Anderson got right there at the buzzer. Yeah, that's the way it goes. The Cardinals fall big, 82-69 here. Well, I guess we go to Saturday night. It'll be Jackson College in here. Tune in on Saturday night for more Cardinal basketball on AUSA. The final games of 2018. The ladies play first, then the men later. Saturday night, we'll be back on the air. Tune in. More Cardinal basketball then. So long from the Andreasen Health and Wellness Center. The final score, Great Lakes Christian College, 82. The Andrews Cardinals, 69.
Thanks. No problem.